Hi everyone, welcome to our video series on finding data. My name is Jaleesa Doney and I'm the Social Sciences Librarian here at the University of Idaho. Throughout this video series, we're going to focus on strategies for specifying your data topics, identifying data creators, searching within data platforms, and evaluating and citing data. In video one, I'm going to introduce a process that can help us ask more precise questions about our research topic and data needs. When we begin our research, we usually have a general idea about our topic, such as investigating whether there is a relationship between educational attainment and poverty in Idaho. A general topic is a great start, but we need to get more specific when looking for existing data related to this topic. One way to do this is to reverse engineer our topic and identify the most significant aspects of our data need, specifically the who, what, when, where, and why. Completing this strategy prior to searching for data ensures that we have a clear understanding of what a data set needs to include in order to meet our needs. Let's go through each of these parts in more detail. The who portion of a topic reveals the sample or population you are interested in. It could be general, such as households, or specific, such as college students who work part-time. Defining the what of a topic allows you to determine the type of data you are looking for. The two main types of data are aggregate data and microdata. Aggregate data is raw data that compiles sets of separate records. Aggregate data is often used to protect the anonymity of survey respondents. Aggregate data often appears in a spreadsheet, such as this one, where the separate or individual level responses from all respondents are compiled based on the county where the respondents live. When the raw data appears as separate records, it is considered microdata. In social science research, microdata can often reflect an individual or a household. As you can see in this example, each row of data is from a single record and represents one individual's responses to specific survey questions. When considering the who and what of your research topic and related data need, it is also important to keep your unit of observation and unit of analysis in mind. In research, the unit of observation is the level at which the data is collected, while the unit of analysis is the level at which the data is analyzed. The unit of observation and the unit of analysis may be the same or different, depending on the questions you ask and how you analyze your results. For example, a unit of observation may be the individual, but if we combine individual responses and analyze our results based on county of residence, our unit of analysis would be the county level. As you progress through your project, keep these units in mind, as they can influence the data you select and how you choose to analyze your data. The when question asks us to consider the age of the data. Depending on your data need, you may be interested in historic data, data from multiple years to investigate changes over time, or the most current data. The where question identifies the location of your sample or population. It could be a specific city, state, country, school, organization, etc. In video 4, we'll talk a bit more about how data sets often include more than one location and how you can focus in on the specific where once the data is downloaded. Lastly, we have the why question, which underpins your entire research topic or question. A few examples of why include testing a hypothesis, practicing statistical analyses or methods, and comparing your data to another data set. Identifying your why is especially important because it can impact which search strategy you use to find relevant data. On the screen right now is an example of what a reverse engineered topic can look like. A reverse engineered topic is a good starting point, but it is important to be flexible when you start searching for data. For example, if we were to encounter date limitations with this sample topic, we would need to be open to either changing our when and utilizing older data, or reworking our topic to reflect the data that is actually available. Coming up in video 2, I'm going to share 3 main strategies for finding data and highlight a few useful data resources.